A
5678. Come on, babe, why don't we paint the town? And all that jazz, I'm gonna rouge my knees and roll my stockings down. And all that jazz, start the car, I know a whoopee spot where the gin is cold but the piano's hot. It's just a noisy hall where there's a nightly brawl and all that jazz. Slick your hair and wear your buckle shoes. And all that jazz, I hear that Father Dip is gonna blow the blues. And all that jazz, hold on, hun, we're gonna bunny hug. I bought some aspirin down at United Drug in case you shake apart and want a brand new start to do that jazz. And all that jazz. And all that jazz. It's just a noisy hall where there's a nightly brawl and all that jazz.
Listen, your husband ain't home, is he?
Husband is not at home. Find a flask, we're playing fast and loose.
And all that jazz.
Right up here is where I store the juice.
And all that jazz. Come on, babe, we're gonna brush the sky. I bet you're lucky, Lindy, never feel so high.
Cause on this stratosphere, we'll be lending ear
to all that jazz.
I'm afraid so, Roxy.
Oh, Fred.
Yeah?
Nobody walks out on me!
But, sweetheart, Roxy, please.
Woo! I gotta pee!
Took the gun officer and I shot him.
I see. And your wife, Roxy Hart, was in no way involved, is that correct?
That is right, officer.
Well, aren't you the little cheerful murderer?
Murderer? Why, just last week, a jury thanked the man for shooting a burglar.
Well, that's just fine. Sign right here, Mr. Hart.
Freely and gladly. Freely and gladly.
For her first number, Miss Roxy Hart would like to sing a song of love and devotion. Dedicated to her dear husband, Amos.
Sometimes I'm right and sometimes I'm wrong, but he doesn't care. He'll string along. He loves me so, that funny honey of mine. Sometimes I'm down and sometimes I'm up, but he follows around like some droopy-eyed pup. He loves me so, that funny honey of mine. He ain't no chic, that's no great. And Lord knows he ain't got the smarts. But look at that soul. I tell you, that hole is a whole lot greater than the sum of his parts. And if you knew him like me, I know you'd agree. What if the world slandered my name? Why, he'd be right there taking the blame. He loves me so, and it all suits me fine. That funny, sunny,
got a right to protect his home and loved ones, right?
Of course he has.
So I come home from the garage, officer, and I see him climbing through the window with my wife Roxanne there, sleeping like an angel.
He loves
an angel.
Me so, that funny honey of mine.
I mean, supposing he had violated her or something. You know what I mean, violated?
I know what you mean.
There's something. Think how terrible that would have been. It's a good thing I came home for work on time, I'm telling you that. I said I'm telling you that.
He loves me so, that funny honey of mine.
Fred Casely?
Fred Casely. How could he be a burglar? My wife knows him. He sold us our
and
furniture.
Lord knows he ain't got the
He told me he was a burglar.
You mean he was dead when you got home?
She had him covered with this white sheet, and she was telling me that constable story about this burglar, and I had to say I did it because I was sure to get off.
Now he shot off his trap. I can't stand that sap.
So she was too tired to be home.
said you'd stick. You want to know what happened? I shot him. Put that in your book, Palsy. And you want to know why? Because he was trying to walk out on me.
That's a pretty cold-blooded murder, Mrs. Hart. They're liable to hang you for that one.
Hang me?
Not so tough anymore, are you?
Amos, did you hear what he just said? Oh, Hail Mary, full of grace.
And now, the merry murderesses of the Cook County Jail in their rendition of the Cell Block Tango.
Cicero.
Lipschitz. Pop. Six.
Squish.
Uh-oh.
Cicero.
Lipschitz. Pop. Six.
Squish.
Uh-oh.
Cicero.
Lipschitz.
Pop.
Six.
Squish.
Uh-oh.
Cicero.
Lipschitz.
He had it coming. He had it coming. He only had himself to blame. If you'd have been there, if you'd have seen it,
get you down, like Bernie. Bernie liked to chew gum. No, not chew. Pop. So I come home this one day, and I'm really irritated, and I'm looking for a little sympathy. And there's Bernie, laying on the couch, drinking a beer and chewing. No, not chewing. Popping. So I say to him, I say, Bernie, you pop that gum one more time. And he did. So I took the shotgun off the wall and I fired two warning shots into his head.
He had it coming. He had it coming. He only had himself to blame. And if you'd have been there, if you'd have heard it, I'll bet you you would have done the same. He had it coming.
I met Ezekiel Young in Salt Lake City 2 years ago, and he told me he was single. And we hit it off right away. So we started living together. He'd go to work, he'd come home, I'd mix him a drink, we'd have dinner. Well, it was like heaven in 2.5 rooms. And then I found out. Single, he told me, single my ass. Not only was he married, oh no, he had 6 wives. One of those Mormons, you know. So that night when he came home, I fixed him his drink as usual. You know, some guys just can't hold their arsenic.
He had it coming.
Six.
He had it coming.
Cicero,
she took a flower.
Six.
And it was five. And then he used it. And he abused it.
Six.
It was a murder, but not a crime.
Cicero, now I'm standing in the kitchen.
Six.
Carving up a chicken for dinner. Minding my own business.
Cicero.
When in storms my husband Wilbur in a jealous rage. You've been seeing the milkman, he said. He was crazy, and he kept screaming,
Cicero.
You've been seeing the milkman. And then he ran into my knife. He ran into my knife 10 times.
If you'd have been there, if you'd have seen it, I'll bet you you would have done the same.
Get us again, it asked more joke. Hold your head is like a emblem folk that I fed your man. Didn't make like chop them up my head. Oh, then, amigos, and not that long for your name to the merit when younger Sam Osh into them. Probably time and then they're shaking me by your ass, they need the merit to take a meg.
But did you do it?
Uh-oh. Not guilty.
He had it come.
My sister Veronica and I did this double act, and my husband Charlie traveled around with us. Now, for the last number in our act, we did these 20 acrobatic tricks in a row. 1, 2, 3, 4, five splits, spread eagles, flip-flops, backflips, one right after the other. Well, this one night we were in Cicero, the three of us sitting up in our hotel room having a few laughs, and we ran out of ice, so I go out to get some. I come back, open the door, and there's Veronica and Charlie doing number 17, the spread eagle. Well, I was in such a state of shock, I completely blacked out. I can't remember a thing. It wasn't until later, when I was washing the blood off my hands, I even knew they were dead. They had it coming. They had it coming. They had it coming all along. I didn't do it, but if I'd done it, how could you tell me that I was wrong?
They had it coming. They had it coming. They had it coming all along. I didn't do it, but if I'd done it, how could you tell me that I was wrong?
He had it coming.
I loved Alvin Lipschitz more than I can possibly say. He was a real artistic guy. Sensitive, a painter, but he was troubled. He was always trying to find himself. He'd go out every night looking for himself, and along the way, he found Ruth, Gladys, Rosemary, and Irving. I guess you could say we broke up because of artistic differences. He saw himself as alive, and I saw him dead.
The dirty hole.
To give. hand washes that one too. When you're good to mama.
The crime of the year, and the news says, not in memory do we recall so fiendish and horrible a double homicide.
Baby, you can't buy that kind of publicity. You took care of Mama, and Mama took care of you.
I talked to Flynn. He set your trial date for March the 5th. March the 7th, you'll be acquitted, and March 8th. Do you know what Mama's gonna do for you? She's gonna start you on a vaudeville tour.
I've been on a lot of vaudeville tours. What kind of dough are we talking about?
Well, I've been talking to the boys at William Morris, and due to your recent sensational activities, I can get you $2,500.
$2,500? The most me and Veronica made was $350.
That was before Cicero, before Billy Flynn, and before Mama.
Mama, I always wanted to play Big Jim Colosimo's. Could you get me that?
Big Jim's, well, that's another story. That might take another phone call.
And how much would that phone call cost?
You know how I feel about you.
You're like family.
I'll do it for $50.
$50 for a phone call? You must get a lot of wrong numbers, Mama.
If you want my gravy, pepper my ragu, spice it up for Mama, she'll get hot for you.
So what's the one conclusion? I can bring this number to
when you're good to Mama.
Chair.
Who the hell do you think you are?
Roxy, this here is Velma Kelly.
Velma Kelly? The Velma Kelly? Oh my gosh! I read about you in the papers all the time. Miss Kelly, could I please ask you something?
What?
Well, the assistant district attorney, Mr. Harrison, said what I'd done is a hanging case, and he's prepared to ask me the maximum penalty. I sure would appreciate some advice.
Look, I don't give advice, and I don't take any advice. You're a perfect stranger to me, and let's keep it that way.
Thanks a lot.
You're welcome.
Roxy, relax. In 47 years, Cook County ain't never hung a woman yet. It's 47-1, they won't hang you.
There's always a first.
So, tell me, Roxy, what are you gonna tell the jury? What are your grounds?
Well, I guess I'll just tell them the truth.
Telling a jury the truth? That's really stupid.
Oh, Jesus, Mary and Joseph, what am I gonna do?
You're talking to the wrong people.
You see, dearie, it's this way. Murder is like divorce. The reasons don't count, it's the grounds. Temporary insanity, self-defense.
Well, yeah, so what are your grounds?
My grounds are that I didn't do it.
So who did?
Well, I'm sure I don't know. I passed out completely. Only I'm sure I didn't do it. I've the tenderest heart in the world. Don't I, Mama?
You bet your ass you do, Velma.
So that's Velma Kelly.
Ain't she something? She wears nothing but black narcissist perfume. Whoa. She wears nothing but black narcissist perfume and never makes her own bed. I take care of that for her.
You make her bed?
No, not exactly. You see, Velma gives me $5 a week. And I give the Hungarian 25 cents and she takes care of it. Hey, Catalin Hanyak!
Sitzerim har megesmern Roxy Hartot.
Not guilty! And that is all she ever says.
Roxy,
know who's defending Velma, don't you?
Who?
Mr. Billy Flynn, best criminal lawyer in all Chicago, that's who.
Well, how do you get Billy Flynn?
First, you give me $50. And then I make a phone call.
I see. And then how much does he get?
Well, $5,000.
$5,000.
I'd be happy to make a phone call for you, dearie.
$5,000. And now where am I gonna get $5,000?
Ladies and gentlemen, a tap dance.
I knew you'd come. I've been sinful, but I want to make it up to you for what I've done. And I will, just as soon as I get out of here. And I can, too. You see, there's this lawyer, and he costs $5,000.
I am tired of your paperwork, Roxy. The answer is no.
I know I've lied to you. I know I've cheated on you. I've even stolen money from your pants pockets while you were sleeping.
Yeah,
but I never stopped loving you. Not my Amos. So manly, so attractive, and so, well, I'm embarrassed. So sexy.
But $5,000.
It's my hour of need.
Okay. Don't worry, Roxy. I'll get you the money. I'll get it.
And gentlemen, presenting the silver-tongued prince of the courtroom, the one, the only, Mr. Billy Flynn.
We want Billy. Where is Billy?
Is everybody here? Is everybody ready? Hit it. I don't care about expensive things. Cashmere coats, diamond rings don't mean a thing. All I care about is love. Studs, satin spats don't mean a thing. All I care about is love.
All he cares about is love.
Give me two eyes of blue, softly saying,
I need you.
Let me see her standing there and honest, mister, I'm a millionaire. I don't care for any fine attire. Vanderbilt might admire. No, no, not me. All I care about is love.
All he cares about is love.
It may sound odd. All I care about is love. Da da dee. Honest to God, all I care about is love.
All he cares about is love.
Show me long raven hair flowing down about to there. Let me see her running free and keep your money, that's enough for me. All I care about is doing the guy in.
Hello, Andy.
Amos. My name is Amos.
Right. Oh, did you bring the rest of the $5,000?
Here is 500 I took up off our insurance and 300 I borrowed from the guys down at the garage, and 700 I took off of the building loan and fund.
That's 1,500.
And that's all I have so far.
Did you ask her father?
I phoned him yesterday. He said he might be able to raise some money later if it was...
You're a liar. I spoke to her father myself, and you know what he said? He said that his daughter went to hell 10 years ago and that she'd stay there before he'd spend a cent on her. That's what he told me.
I'll give you $20 off of my salary every week. I'll give you notes with interest, double, triple, till every cent is paid.
That's touching, but I have a motto, and it's play square, dead square. Now, when you came to me yesterday, I didn't ask if she was guilty. No, I didn't ask if she was innocent. No foolish questions like that. Now, did I? All I asked was, have you got the $5,000? And you said yes. But you haven't got the $5,000, so I figure you're a dirty liar.
I'm sorry, Mr. Flynn.
But I took her case, and I will keep it because I play square. Now, here's what we're gonna do. I'm gonna get her name in every paper as the hottest little jazz slayer since Velma Kelly. And then afterwards, we're gonna raise money for her defense. We'll sell everything she's ever touched. Dresses, shoes, underwear. And if by due process of law, she gets hanged.
Hanged?
The stuff triples in value. And you get to keep 20% of everything we make over 5,000. That's what I call playing square.
I don't know, Mr. Flynn.
You see, it's like this. Either I get the entire 5,000, or you rot in jail before I bring you to trial. Now, in a couple of minutes, there's gonna be a big press conference. There'll be photographers and reporters, and that sob sister from the Evening Star is coming, Mary Sunshine.
Mary Sunshine is gonna interview me? Holy crap!
Hey! Pipe it down on the swearing. From now on in, you don't say anything rougher than, oh dear, got it? So now we're gonna have to go after the sympathy of the press. They're not all pushovers like that Mary Sunshine. Chicago is a tough town. So tough, in fact, that they shoot the girls right out from under you. But I've got one thing they cannot resist, and that's a reformed sinner. So I've decided to rewrite your life from convent to jail. Get this. Beautiful southern home. Every luxury and refinement. Parents dead, educated at the Sacred Heart. Fortune swept away. A innocent girl, bewildered by what's happened. Full of life, lonely. You were caught up in the mad whirl of a great city. Jazz, cabarets, liquor, sit down. You were drawn like a moth to the flame. And when that mad whirl has ceased, a butterfly, crushed under the wheel. You have sinned and you are sorry.
That's beautiful.
Now, when you're on the witness stand, all you can remember is a fearful quarrel and he threatened to kill you. You can still see him coming towards you with that awful look in his eyes. And get this, you both reach for the gun. That's your grounds, self-defense.
Mr. Flynn, the reporters are here.
Let him in, Mama. Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Sunshine. You know my client, Roxy Hart?
Ladies and gentlemen, I am just so flattered y'all came to see little old me. I guess you want to know why I shot him, the rat.
Sit down, dummy.
Mr. Billy Flynn sings the press conference rag. Notice how his mouth never moves. Almost.
We
where'd you come from?
Mississippi.
And your parents?
Very wealthy.
Where are they now?
6 feet under, but she was granted one more start, the coffin of the Sacred Heart.
When'd you get here?
1920.
How old were you?
Don't remember.
Then what happened?
I met Amos, and he stole my heart away, convinced me to elope one day.
A convent girl, a runaway marriage, oh, it's too terrible, you poor, poor dear.
Who is Frank Casely?
My ex-boyfriend.
Why'd you shoot him?
I was leaving.
Was he angry?
Like a madman. Still I said, friend, move along. She knew that she was doing wrong.
Then describe it.
He came toward me
with a pistol
from my bureau.
Did you fight him?
Like a tiger. He had strength and she had none. And yet we both reached for the gun. Oh yes, oh yes, oh yes, we both. Oh yes, we both. Oh yes, we both reached for the gun. The gun, the gun, the gun. Oh yes, we both reached for the gun. For the gun.
Oh yes, they both,
reach
for the gun, the gun, the gun, the gun. Oh yes, they both reach for the gun.
Understandable, yes, it's perfectly understandable. Comprehensible, not a bit reprehensible. It's so defensible.
How you feeling?
Very frightened.
Are you sorry?
Are you kidding?
What's your statement?
All I'd say is, don't mind shoot you, jump the track. I'd give my life to bring him back.
And
stay away from
what?
Jazz and liquor.
And
the men who
what?
Play for fun.
And what?
That's the thwart that
yeah.
came upon me
when
we both reached for the gun.
Understandable,
yes, it's perfectly understandable. Comprehensible, not a bit reprehensible. It's so let me hear it.
The gun. Oh yes, they both reach for the gun. For the gun.
A little louder.
Oh yes, they both. Oh yes, they both reach for the gun. Oh yes, they both reach for the gun. For the gun.
Now you got it.
Jazz Slayer.
Roxy Salt, I'd give anything to bring him back.
You want to know something? I always wanted my name in the papers. Before Amos, I used to date this well-to-do, ugly bootlegger. He used to like to dress me up and take me out and show me off. You know, once it said in the papers, Gangland's Al Capelli seen at Che Vito with cute redheaded Corrine. That was me. So I clipped it out and I saved it. Now look, Roxy Rock Chicago, yes! I'm gonna tell you the truth.
And not that the truth really matters, but I'm gonna tell you anyways. You see, I'm older than I ever intended to be. All my life I wanted to be a dancer in vaudeville, have my own act. Oh yeah. But no, 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 no. It was one big world full of no. Life. And then Amos came along. Sweet, safe Amos, who never said no. You know, some guys are like mirrors, and when I catch myself in Amos's face, I'm a kid again. You could love a guy like that. So I gave up the vaudeville idea, because after all those years, you sort of just figure opportunity just passed you by. But it ain't. Oh, no, 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 but it ain't. If this Flynn guy can get me off, and with all this publicity, I could still get into vaudeville. I could still have my own act. And then I got me a world full of yes! The name on everybody's lips is gonna be Roxy. The lady raking in the chips is gonna be Roxy. I'm gonna be a celebrity, that means somebody everyone knows. Some dumb mechanic's wife, I'm gonna be Roxy. Who says that murder's not an art? And who, in case she doesn't hang, can say she started with a bang? Foxy, Roxy Hart. Wah, 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 wah. I'm gonna have me a swell act too. Oh yeah, I'll get a boy to work with. Oh hell, I'll get two boys. It'll frame me better. Think big, Roxy, think big. Oh, don't my dancers just look wonderful today?
She's gonna be a celebrity.
That means somebody everyone knows.
They're gonna recognize her eyes, her hair, her teeth,
my legs, my nose. From just some dumb mechanic's wife, I'm gonna be singing
Roxy.
Yeah.
Oh,
Anne's ride at Roxy Auction.
Roxy's nightie raises $200.
Mama, you know I'm not a jealous person, but every time I see that tomato's name on the front page, it drives me nuts.
Baby, I got some bad news.
What do you mean?
I mean the tour. It's canceled.
Canceled?
Well, your name hasn't been in the papers for a long time. I've been getting calls from the boys all day. We don't want her. She's washed up. She's a bum. Do you know how it hurts Mama to hear things like that about someone she cares for?
Oh, sure.
All you hear about today is the heart, kid.
Hey, Mama. I've got an idea. Suppose I talk Hart into doing that sister act with me.
Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Velma Kelly in an act of desperation.
My sister and I had an act that couldn't flop. My sister and I were headed straight for the top. My sister and I earned $1,000 a week at least. But my sister is now unfortunately deceased. I know it's sad, of course, but a fact is still a fact. And now all that remains is the remains of a perfect double act. Roxy, do you know that you are the exact same size as my sister? You would fit in her wardrobe perfectly. Look, why don't I show you some of the act, huh? Watch this. Two people. It's swell with two people. First, I'd drum it. Then she'd wah 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 saxophone. Then we'd together, but I can't do it alone. Then she'd. Sister like, I'd say men, yuck, yuck, yuck. She'd say, are the cats meow? Then we'd wow the crowd again when she'd go. I'd go. The best attraction in town. They nearly tore the balcony down. And we'd say, okay, boys, we're going home, but here's a few more parting shots. And this we did in perfect unison.
In jail now. I mean, there was a time where you could go to jail and get a really
okay,
nice...
Okay, Roxy, I'll level with you.
Didn't you hear what Mama just said? It's me they want now. Haven't you read the papers lately? I'm a star. A big star single.
Thanks.
It's nothing personal, you know.
Nothing personal. Nothing's ever personal. Like
A deserted bride on her wedding night, all alone and shaking with fright, with her brand new hubby nowhere in sight. I simply cannot do it alone.
All right, so here's the way I got the story. There's this Kitty, something or other, I didn't catch her last name. Anyway, she's some sort of heiress. Her folks are in pineapples, grapefruits, something like that. Well, she's playing house in a north side apartment with a guy named, Harry. Last night, this Kitty dame comes home. Harry's already in bed. She goes to change, and when she returns, she notices something rather odd.
Oh, Harry!
Okay, are you gonna believe what you see, or what I tell you?
What I say! Duo in bed! Wolf dead!
My client will be happy to answer all of your questions. Ow, will you stop biting me? I'll get hydrophobia.
I'm not answering any more questions.
Come on, dearie. I'll show you to your suite. You're gonna love it.
Wait a minute. Do you know who my father is?
Who?
Well, he owns all of Hawaii. Now let me go, you chunk of lead.
Just follow me in here. My client will be happy to answer all of your questions, and afterwards I'll be happy to give you an interview myself.
Mr. Flynn!
Hi, Mr. Flynn.
Hiya, Trixie.
Trixie!
Oh, I mean Roxy. Boy, what a hellion, huh? And a socialite, too. Her mother owns all the pineapples in Hawaii.
What do I care? Did you get my trial date?
I'm working on it, kid.
Mr. Flynn, there's a couple of things I'd like to discuss about my trial, too.
Oh, hiya, Velma. All right, first things first, kid. Mary Sunshine? Can I call you Mary? The girl from Old Pineapple Money. It's a gripping story, really.
Pineapples. I got a feeling you're in trouble now, Roxy.
Socialite. You lose again, Velma.
There's only one person that can help you now, Roxy.
There's only one person you can count on now, Velma.
And now, Miss Roxy Hart and Miss Velma Kelly sing a song of unrelenting determination and unmitigated ego.
sunshine and all you reporters. Don't worry about me. It's just that I'm gonna have a baby.
A baby?
Crap!
I need the best doctor in town for my client. And will somebody pick her up?
And the